Well, how do that, chums? As I, Captain Steven, today, chums, for you guys out there in the viewerverse, I'm going to be creating myself a very evil sort of cake. The cake's name is the Apple Cake of Lost Souls. Yes. Now, you need apples. Now, you need crab apples at that. So, to get these apples, you need to grab them from crabs, because they're crab apples. Right, so I need to go and feed some crabs, and lucky enough, on my Diplo World, NMSA Diplo Hub, I have crabs. Two different varieties of crabs. They're both quite rare, but they seem to frequent pondy-type areas like this, and they tend to appear during the daytime. So it's now daytime. Is there a crab? There's one over there. Right, we're going to head on over, and we're going to go feed this crab. Now, I am going to create some auto-feeders here as well, and make a little base that looks like a crab. Righto, so I think this would be a perfect spot, because there's two large crabs in nearby vicinity. Right, so let's put down a best computer. Ah, lovely jubbly, there it is. And let's hit on this up, and let's claim this area as mine. Yes, this will be my base, this will be my home. Excellent, eh? Kaboom! Chicka-pow-pow, chicka-boom-boom. There you go, please subscribe, it really helps the channel. It does, and that's my new merch. Heck yes, t-shirt! There's also an Executamondo t-shirt. There we go, that's all the plugs I'm going to do, sorry for that. Right, so let's head on down here. It's dead space anyway, isn't it? That bit, that animation, so yeah, why the fudge not? So let's head on down here, and let's put down my base by that crab creature. And like I say, I'm going to make this base look like a crab. So first of all, I need to get one of the cinder rooms to be hovering above the ground. Now, this is probably the hardest part of this build, and pretty much the rest of the build is going to be self-explanatory, really, so I'm just going to speed up the footage and play some music when I start the actual build itself, because it's a really simple build, and I've made a video on this already, how to make a crab base. I put a video card in the top right-hand corner if you want to go check that out in slow-mo. Right, so here we go, let's put that on there. Speed up footage, play tune. Captain, Steve, I do the things you do. Captain Steve, oh Captain Steve, I wanna play the game with you. Captain Steve, Captain Steve, oh Captain, Captain. There you go, I hope you enjoyed that earworm of a tune. It's probably made your ears bleed, actually, hasn't it? Anyway, people, I've made my base and I've uploaded my base as crab feeder. However, daytime came and no crabs spawned anywhere near it. So now I'm having to run over and feed the crabs manually. Hello there, crab creature. Come and have a snack on this. Yes, there's some creature pellets for you and your buddy. Yes, I want your apples. Yes, I want to pinch some apples off of you, my little crabby friend. So lovely jubbly, let's scoop keep these. Lovely. Thank you. Got myself 3 crab apples from you. And this one is a Scottish rod. Hello there, Scottish rod. I want to pinch your apples. Yes, I do. I want some off of you. How many am I going to get? I got another 3. A trio of appiels. Lovely. Awesome. Right, so I guess we could head back to my base and start putting these in the refiner, couldn't we? You know what I do need, though? I need some of this. Cactus flesh. Yes, because I need to sort of break this down and make some stuff out of that. So there we go. Put that there. I think it's sugar that I need from that, the refined sugar. Could be wrong. I think it is sugar. Right, so let's head on over here. Or is it something else? I can't remember. But when we get to the nutrient processor, it should pop up in what I want to do. It turns into some sort of weird green liquid. And then you put that in and it turns into the other commodity that I need. If it's not the sugar, then I may need to get some frost crystal, turn that into glass bits and bobs, glass particles, and then I think that turns into the sugar. I can't remember which is which. Anyway, let's head on in and let's go to my nutrient process and we'll have a play. We'll do some experimentation. Awesome. But before we go there, I need to get myself some larval cores. So I'm going to go to my rusted planet. So any airless world will be good to get yourself some larval cores. Right, so this planet, Alice World, I'm looking for the icon that looks like it's got a little alien-type face-hugger egg. Right, so I think I can actually see one. I think there's one just over there. Righto, yeah, this way. Look, you see it? There it is. There's the icon I'm on about, that red one that just popped up very quickly. But we can see it with the beady, beady, naked eye. Right, so let's head on over and let's pop this. And let's get ready to grab this larval core and then run back to our base to take cover. Now, I'm going to grab 3 of these or so. Right, there we go. We've got a larval core. Let's leg it. Now, these creatures at the moment can jump a terribly big distance. There seems to be a bit of a bug. It's going to be fixed in the next experimental update. It's in the patch list. It's on PC, experimental branch, as we speak, chums. So there we go. I'm going to grab some more of them. Right, so I'm teleporting back to my other base. It's my crab base that I just built. Yes, yeah, the fandangly one you just saw me do in fast motion. Heck yes. And we're back. Awesome. Right, you know what I need to do? I need to load up all the feeders underneath this, don't I? I need to load up all of those because I need to grab a load of milk before we start having a play with the nutrient processor. So here we go. You know what? I'm going to stick a load of these creature pellets in here. Yeah, put some in there. I'll put some in this one over here. Then I'm going to do the other two. And we're going to let it just feed a few creatures. I'm going to play some more funky music. Was you singing that song along with us, Captain? Captain, I bet you was inside of your head. Yes, earworm time. Right, there we go. We've got a shed load of freaking milk now. I wonder if there's anything in this one. Hopefully there is. Let's have a quick look-see. Yes, we've got 2 more milks. Lovely job. Well, we can make the cream out of that. I think it's nutrient processor time, people. Let's go through the crab's mouth. Oh, completely fudged that up, didn't I? Pretend I did that right first time. Heck yes. Yes, here we go. Nutrient processor. Hello there, nutrient processor. Right, so I'm going to put the milk in here. That should turn into cream. And then hopefully after the cream is processed, I chuck that back in, I think. Yes, do I put this back in? I think I do. And then that should turn into some butter. Yes, yes, it's what is that? Clarified butter or something weird like that. Lovely jubbly. We've got our butter. Anyway, churned butter. Thank you, churned butter. Stick that over there. As you know, yes, we do. No, we don't. We take it back out. Right, now I'm going to do the stuff with the cactus flesh. So here we go. It turns into this cactus nectar. Then after I've got the cactus nectar, let's just put that back in there. Pick this up, put it over here. What does it turn into? Oh, it does turn into the refined sugar. Right, brilliant. So that turns into the refined sugar. And I think I'm going to need the frost crystal to turn into these glass sort of particles. And then the glass particles, I think, turn into a flour, if I'm right. Right, here we go. Awesome. So we've got our sugar there. Now, if I put the butter there, that should give us sweetened butter. Heck yes, it does. Lovely jubbly. Awesome, super, smashing and great. Now, I'm going to put these back into here. The reason I'm taking them out is hopefully it's going to add to my catalogue if I haven't already got one there. So I'm growing some cactus. I'm also going to grow some frost crystal actually in here. But here we go. We've got the frost crystal. Let's put that in there. And that turns into these sort of like little glassy granules or whatever, glass grains. Yeah, you don't really want that in your food, do you? That's going to serrate your frickin' throat, isn't it? Nice. Yeah, I don't even know why that's a cookery sort of ingredient. Right, so there we go. I'm just going to put these back into there before I put them back into the processor, just to give you a bit of time to track what I'm doing. Glass granules, there we are, that's the flour. Awesome, processed flour, lovely job. And we grab that. Awesome. So this is getting all the ingredients for that evil freaking cake. Apple cake of lost souls. Lost souls apple cake. Right, don't see this on the Bake Off all too often. Right, so here we go. Let's grab that. And now I feel like, do I need the lava course? No, I'm going to put that in there. And yes, I do need the lava course, but I'm going to keep some back. There we go. That's going to make whaling butter. Sweet flour with the sweetened butter with a lava core. I'm going to stick that back over this side. Cool. So we've got the whaling butter. Lovely. And now I think I just need to add the crab apple. And it should give me the cake of lost souls. Yes, the apple cake of lost souls will be mine in like 2 seconds. Here we go. Boom. One, two. Buckle my shoe. Awesome. Here we go. Into my inventory with you. Heck yes. Surplus materials. Awesome. In your face, Mary Berry. Heck yes, you soggy bottom sort of... I don't know. I can't really say too much about Mary Berry. She's a freaking institution. She's a lovely lady as well. Heck yeah, she is. Mary Berry, you're awesome. So is Matt Berry. I don't know whether you're related, but yes, Matt Berry is one of my freaking idols, I guess. Yes, I do like Matt Berry and his comical style. You probably can notice in my twang. Anyway, if you want to come here, it's in Euclid. And it's also in the NMSA Hub. Come along. Take a look there. Awesome. There we go, people. Till next time, you've been great. Goodbye, goodbye, and goodbye again. Well, thank you very much for watching. If you like what you see, please hit a like and a subscribe. And I'd like to say a massive great big thank you to all of my backers over on Patreon and over on YouTube membership. Thanking you, backers. And if you want to support this channel, just don't skip the adverts. That throws revenue down my avenue. Or yeah, just stay with Captain Steve a little bit longer and hit something on this screen. There's merch here now too.